Esto es la buena vida.
Hola amigos de la buena vida, welcome to the Good Life Show. We are making an amazing and different show today. We are in St. Helens Beach. And like every weekend, I hope you will enjoy tomorrow weekend. And we're having a really nice summer. It's very warm summer, very hot, I would say. And because about Latino culture, we're gonna talk about this on this show today. We have two important Latino guests. The beach, not the studio there, the beach. They are making a lot of Latino input, a lot of Latino push to the Kiwi society. And they've been doing this for years. Gerardo Torres.
Hello, Gerardo. Frank.
Welcome to the Gula Show.
Thank you very much for your invitation. Ready to answer your questions this beautiful afternoon in La Buena Vida.
Thank you. Welcome to the La Buena Vida. Bienvenido a La Buena Vida, Gerardo Torres. Gerardo Torres ha estado haciendo Latino music. He's been making Latino music for over 20 years in New Zealand. But before he came to New Zealand, he was making music in Peru.
Ay! I decided to put together this band a long time ago. As soon as I arrived to New Zealand, I put together a live band, 14-piece band. But obviously the market was very difficult to keep it, you know. But after that I realized that I should put up a smaller size, and I put Matecito.
Our next guest, his name is Eduardo Segueiros. Eduardo.
Thank you very much, Frank. Thank you for inviting me, us, to this beautiful day at La Buena Vida, and we are very happy to be here with you, and let's discuss about any matters you would like to talk about.
Gracias, Eduardo. Eduardo, he's the leader of the band Banda Latina, I would say in English, Latin band. He's been performing the Banda Latina for more than 20 years, that's right, and in just in New Zealand, but he's been a musician for all his life. So you think that when you think it's just a lot of dancing in schools in New Zealand, it's because people, they go to dancing, but I wouldn't say they don't think that they don't realize that you're working that night. But at the end of the night, you ended up with no money because the place is full of people. 400 or 500 people, they are dancing. But the bar is, they are not busy at all.
Well, perhaps not that we are finishing and we don't get any money, but we identify ourselves with the owners of the band because they put their money to try to make some money. It's like any business, you know?
It's like any business, that's
and,
right.
And of course, if they don't make money, they can't keep like that.
Yeah, we sort of work together with the owners of the venues because we understand that they have a business, and the fact of using a band means that they need to attract people to come into the bar or the restaurant, but they need to consume. They need to spend their money at the bar or at the restaurant so they can make enough money to pay the band. So that is when we need to work with them, and we need the support of people coming to dance, not only just to dance for free, but also to put some money into the business, to help the business so the business can actually pay us, and in that way support the whole Latin American, you know, art of dancing and singing salsa, in our case, for example.
So definitely, we need to point it out that, as in New Zealand, we need the support for people. If you want to keep dancing, or going to the Latino parties, so you have to not just drink water, you have to drink some wine, spend some money, and to support the band. Yes. Doesn't matter if you have to pay for the cover, sometimes you have to, because they are working for you. So now, let's go with the video.
We're a resident band at the Kingsland there. It is in Kingsland Road in Kingsland. We have been a resident band there for the last 6 years, and we had a great, great response. It has built a very good reputation, and we have the place packed every Wednesday. It's 470 New North Road, just in case you want to come around and have a good dance of salsa and Latin music with us. Frank was very nice to come and see us and do this beautiful video of this song, the song called Salsa con Coco. So you watch us how we dance and perform on the stage, and you can see how people can enjoy dancing to our music. This is Banda Latina. Gracias.
Esto es la buena vida.
Vacilar, la luna en la mañana, dejando a los. You don't have to be shy anymore, eh?
Salsa con Coco, con la banda latina y Eduardo Segueiros, que cada miércoles, every Wednesday night, you can watch it in the Kingslander, in Kingsland. So you think people are still ignore when you performing your band? Because some bands in New Zealand, while you performing, they are just chatting each other, but they are forgetting that it's a band in front of them.
I believe that you're saying that when we're performing, people sometimes don't even listen to us, or they look like they are not listening to us. Indeed, yeah, it happens a lot, eh?
Ah, okay, okay.
Yeah, I think it's part of the New Zealand culture. Could we say that, or it's part of the New Zealand habits of having a band in front of them, in any venue, and they sort of take for granted that the band is going to play, but the audience doesn't need to sort of acknowledge their presence.
Yes.
And we have found that as well. And I remember a little anecdote that when we started playing with the band right at the very beginning, we didn't have much experience on the stage. We actually thought that there was something wrong with our music. But no, a few years later, we realized that that's part of the New Zealand culture. Sometimes they just don't applaud you after we finish a song. That's because it's what they do, not because they are not listening to us.
Okay.
So yeah, we found that kind of thing happening to us. What do you think, Gerardo?
I think I had just an experience with another band that I was playing when I arrived to New Zealand. I was gigging with the Garden City Big Band, a 20-piece band, terrific background, terrific musician, and we were finishing a terrific song, and people just ignored.
How many people was there at that time?
And I said to them,
yes.
Hey guys, if you would be in my country, I tell you what, people are gonna give you a big round of applause.
Yeah. They just clap.
Yeah, yes. At least.
Because
when the song, people, they're really happy. Otra, they wanna hear another song.
But the band leader told me, Gerardo, I know what you mean. Mm. This is our world. This is culturally. And wow, I said, very cool, mate.
Perhaps we Latin Americans are used to that warmth from the audience, that's what happens in South America. You play a nice song, you enjoy yourself on a stage, because that's what we do. You know, we enjoy a song, we sing the song, and we give that to the audience, and we expect them to probably have the same feeling. And then suddenly, when we finish, they just look at you or don't do anything.
Yes.
But we feel the difference, indeed.
Yeah, but in my case, I face different kind of audiences. And sometimes, especially in big events like festivals and things like that, when you don't have just the normal people, you have people that never you saw them, and they get mad, especially when they are with a few drinks on.
That is something that happens. Many times we need to wait for them to have a couple of beers or a couple of glasses of wine, and then we'll be on the dancing floor dancing. Maybe because they sort of lost that in inhibition that they have at the beginning, and say, okay, that music actually sounds nice. They have a bit of alcohol and go to the dancing floor and enjoy our music.
So perhaps because in Latin America, we already broke the ice, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, we did indeed.
But in New Zealand, we need to break the ice as well?
But I think New Zealanders, they need something to drink.
Let's go to the next video. The next video, we went last Wednesday to the city to make a video about Gerardo Torres and the Matecito band. So tell us a little bit about what happened the last Wednesday, Gerardo.
Thank you for coming to the Deluxe, as the new Latin venue in town. It's 146 K Road. Almost in the intersection with Queen Street. So every Wednesday we are there, and everybody welcome. Now because people are not drinking, we put a cover charge. So it's just a modest $5 anyone can pay. So it's $5 and you get a drink.
That place is called
Deluxe.
Deluxe.
Now you can come and dance. You don't have to be shy anymore, eh? Thank you.
pueden disfrutar lo mejor de la banda Matecito, liderada por Gerardo Torres, cada miércoles en la noche, every Wednesday night. So, is any clash between musicians when musicians are performing? I know you're really good friends. Even you belong to the same country.
Indeed.
But is it any clash between musicians, any new musicians, they want to perform in New Zealand and they become enemies because they don't want to meet each other and they don't want to play in the same place and maybe they are quite jealous?
If they want to be my enemies, that's their problem. I don't have any issue with anybody. And a special friendship is with Eduardo.
We have been friends for many years. We perform almost the same kind of music. We lead our own bands, but we have never been into any kind
trouble.
Of conflict or trouble because we respect each other, which is a very, very important thing as artists, as people who are giving, you know, our art to the New Zealand community.
And we have been playing together as well.
Indeed, we have sometimes mixed the bands together. We put a huge show by putting the two bands together. And we help each other and we support each other, rather.
You as a Latino musician performing for many years, do you think that the public is ready for the new bands, the new blood, for the new future in New Zealand?
We really have hopes that these people are actually learning more and more every year that passes about Latin music, about salsa. Mm-hmm. And more New Zealanders are actually dancing salsa. So I believe that probably in a few years, people will keep taking this music that we give them, incorporating into their environment, and enjoy our music. What do you think, Gerardo?
Yeah, well, same like you said before. I think commitment. If you really want to be in the Latin scene, it's commitment, dedication. On Matecito Latin Band, we do our best all the time to try to improve.
Definitely.
Maybe what we need to do is to put more music videos in the TV.
Like that is C4, a great
because
idea.
Because if C4 is just English.
Yeah, exposure.
We
can tell people, let more people know that this is what we do.
Yes.
And our music is attractive, it's energetic, it's dynamic, it's actually happy music. Anyone, we will play a salsa to anyone, even if it's from New Zealand or from any other country, they will enjoy it.
Yes. Mm.
They will enjoy
it. It's because people, they think, this is what really pointed out this, because people, they think that salsa music belongs to South America, belongs to Latino culture. But probably what we need to push now is that salsa music belongs to New Zealand as
well. Anyone can enjoy it.
Yes.
And they can do it, they can dance it, they can just come and practice, they will learn it, and they will enjoy dancing salsa with us.
Exactly.
We can teach them. And that's what we do in New Zealand.
It's addicted.
It is, really.
So we need more public, we need new people, probably the New Zealand society is becoming more familiar. And
indeed.
It's because just salsa music is not an ethnic from Latino.
It's universal
from
now.
From the Latino community. It's because salsa music is part of New Zealand.
It is.
Yes.
Okay.
But not just salsa. We play a variety. Well, we use the word salsa for expressing
bachatas,
cumbias,
cha-cha-cha.
All of these.
You
boleros,
know?
Inclusive.
Yeah, boleros as well. You know.
When talking about boleros, now, talking about boleros, we're going to Cuba to meet Isbert Ramos. He is better well known as a Vivio in the Good Life Show. He is a Cuban entrepreneur living in New Zealand for quite a long time, many years. And he has his own business in Auckland. So let's meet Vivio in the Good Life Show.
Now you can come and dance. You don't have to be shy anymore, eh?
Hola latinos, hola neozelandeses. Yo soy Vivio y si quieren aprender a bailar salsa cubana, aquí me tienen en Grayling. Soy en Grecia en 92 y esto es para la buena vida, para New Zealand. Mira, lo máximo, lo mejor, la rumba, mambo, cha cha cha. Son para que no te equivoques, que tampoco es reggaetón. Esto es salsa cubana que tiene sabroso, tabaco y ron. Y está rico para ti, así que ven. Gracias. Mira, paso uno. Paso dos. Paso tres. Paso cuatro. Open break. What we call open break. Remember? Can you read again? Vamos a tour. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Cinco, seis, siete, ocho. One, two, three, four. Five, six, seven, eight. Remember that four and eight are on the middle. That eight. One, two, three, four. 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 And that's all we want to do now. Paso cinco. Yeah. Oh, oh, hey. Yeah. Ahora vamos a hacer sombrero, así que te enseño que es sombrero esta cuba, ¿sabes? Sombrero lo fresco. You go to sombrero fresco, right? Sí. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. One, three, five, dile que no. One, two, three, five, six, seven, open. And we're gonna go there slowly, right? Y, tap, one, two, three, five, six, seven, undo, one, two, three, five, six, seven, one, two, three, woo, dile que no.
Amigos, esto es La Buena Vida.
Now you can come and dance. You don't have to be shy anymore, eh?
Bueno, y con la banda Latina y con la banda Maticito Band. hechas aquí en Nueva Zelanda, muy reconocidas. We unfortunately have to say that we live in now our magazine show, but the next week we have another spectacular show, perhaps like this one with the beach. We use the beach as a studio, and let's enjoy La Buena Vida show the next week with another new episode here in the Good Life Show. Thank you. Recuerden que nuestra cultura latina está en todos lados, y en Nueva Zelanda también.
Now you can come and dance. You don't have to be shy anymore, eh?